I mean, Tonga is isolated. It's small. They're not equipped to deal with a large-scale crisis like COVID-19. I'm originally from Pennsylvania in the United States, but I've been living in New Zealand for a long time in Auckland, and I'm currently in Nuku'alofa, Tonga.
Technically, I'm based in Auckland, at the University of Auckland, but then I'm here for research.
I think there were multiple stories going around about how long the lockdown was actually supposed to be. Some people were saying, oh, we're doing this for a month. Some said 2 weeks. Officially, it is 1 week, but it'll probably be extended. And also confusion around with some people, like, why are we even doing this lockdown if COVID-19 isn't here?
The government is implemented this lockdown in order to train law enforcement and military in the event that the coronavirus may reach Tonga. Yeah, so one of the biggest things I think the government is working on as far as like listening to the radio and reading the news is trying to have testing kits here in Tonga instead of having to send the blood work overseas.
Generally, Pacific Islands don't have the resources that other places do. The medical facilities and things like that. That's a big concern. I think the first thing that Tonga will be affected by is the overseas remittances. So that's the Tongans living overseas sending money to family back here.
You could say that most families here in Tonga know somebody or have a family member overseas, and a lot of them which are receiving some type of remittances or some type of income or money from family. So,
if Tongans living in New Zealand, Australia, United States are losing their sources of income, they won't really have much to send back to here. And that's a huge thing.
The measures that the Tongan government has taken thus far has given me kind of a sense of hope or a sense of, I guess a sense of hope that they're doing everything that they need to do to prevent the virus from getting here.
I see what's going on back in the States, and it's very individualistic there, as we hear on the news. But here in Tonga, I feel like people pull together really well, and I would just like to see those cultural attributes be utilized to the fullest extent.